awake, are we? I heard you've been in an accident. Well, when I first heard the news, I thought, good, I hope he dies. Because, Gaz Wilkinson, you have ruined my life, not once, not twice, but over and over and over. And then I got to thinking, why am I driving to the hospital so fast just to see if he's dead? Well, if he's not, maybe it's so that I can hold a pillow over his face, or put little razor nicks in his bell end until he wakes up, and then hold the aforementioned pillow over his face. And then a week later, when I was still sat here, day after day, not so much as changing my clothes, which is why I smell like a horse. I started thinking, am I an idiot? And I am, and every time I washed you or shouted at the nurses for not having any answers, I thought, why am I doing this for this horrible, stupid man? And when the paramedics told me that it was me you'd asked for at the scene, why did I care, Gaz? And there's only one answer. I love you. And I hate myself for it, but I do. And I know you love me too. That's just the way that it is. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to sort this out, me and you. And we're going to start again. And from now on, it's just me and you. I know, yeah, Corinthian, that bloody baby. Well, it's going to be a tough one. Is that? Well, you know, for God's sakes, you know, if I can get over that, if I can get over everything that you've put me through and still be here, you bastard, then you can do every single thing in your power to make this work. Okay? Okay, just blink once for yes and twice for no.
It's always been you.
You slept with Gaz.
I just need to talk to Donna.
Zoe.
And punch her in the tits.